I think MLOps engineers and like data engineers sometimes they think too much like engineers. Like sometimes they're not.
Can you elaborate more on that?
I can elaborate more on that. A lot of times they think, I don't want to say they think the challenges are technical. A lot of times there are technical challenges, but a lot of times what you actually need to get is you need to get time and like headroom and investment. And a lot of times that means aligning your conversation with the strategic goals of the business. And I think a lot of data engineers and like MLOps engineers are not really great with that. I think data scientists oftentimes can be better at that. And so when they make...
Because they need to deal with business more often.
Yep,
right?
Yep.
And MLOps kind of are not providing direct value, right?
You know, it's like public health, right? Like everyone undervalues public health until you're dying of like a water contagion issue, right? Like it is super important, but people don't always surface how important it is. And more importantly, a lot of times they approach it from the best technical solution, as opposed to this will drive immense value for the company. And companies really care only about like two or three things, right? They care about generating more revenue or more profit, right? You don't want to generate more revenue, more costs, right? Generate more revenue or profit, cut down costs or like optimize them, and then do some combination of both.
So profit.
Yeah, effectively, right? So if MLOps engineers and data engineers can align their efforts, especially around building an ML stack, right? Because a lot of times, like, a business person is going to be like, or even like a head of engineering, they're going to be like, why do we need this tool? Like, it's just another thing that people here are not going to be using. And the very easy way to, the strategy to kind of counter that is, one, like, think about what KPIs and metrics they care about. Show the impact on those. The next part is also offering like a plan of attack and a plan of like maintenance. And the thing that I've observed really successful ML platform teams do is kind of almost counter to the stories that you hear about. So a lot of the stories you hear about building ML platforms is like, oh, we created this new thing and then we brought in this tool to do it. And then people just used it and loved it. It's just another version of the, if you build it, they will come. And that's just not what happens. Like if you actually read between the lines of a lot of like successful ML platforms, what they did was they took on like an area or a stage of the process that was already, it was already going, but it wasn't optimal. It was very suboptimal. Like maybe they already had a path to production for like, you know, for deploying machine learning models. But it just really sucked. And so what teams would do is they would build a parallel solution that was just much better. And then they would essentially like invite or like onboard like data scientists to that path. They would do the manual stuff associated sometimes with adopting users. Like the whole, you know, do things that don't scale. You know, do workshops. You know, help them like get their projects through the door. The key point is you have to offer something that is actually truly better, because when data scientists or users have a baseline of we do this thing already, but it really sucks, and then you offer them something better. I think there's a term called differentiable value or something. You essentially have a user base already of like data scientists that can do more things. So if you go to like a business person or your like CTO and go like, look, we already know we have 100 data scientists that are trying to push models. This is how long it's taking them. We can cut, not only can we cut that time down to half, but we can also do it in a way where they're happier about it and they're not going to quit. And it'll provide X amount more value because these are the initiatives like we want to push. And it's going to take us like 6 months to do it. But we can make sure we can cut down to 3 months. And then you can show those benchmarks and measurements. as well as offer like, hey, this is our like maintenance plan. Like a lot of these conversations, once again, they're not about technical supremacy. It's about how do you like socialize that initiative? How do you like align it with like your like executive leaders, their concerns? And then doing the hard work of like getting the adoption in like the ML platform.